sir, it's time for Wrestling Night in Kansas City. Dr. Wrestling Midnight Guthrie welcoming you to the finest hour of professional wrestling action in the Midwest today. Great to have you, wrestling fans, together. Let's celebrate the pinnacle of American arts and athletics, professional wrestling. We start things off with the Danimal, Dan Walsh, coming to ringside with Lucy Mendez. Dan Walsh recently lost the Central States Championship to SBC. Never shy
Kansas
with the mic.
City, why do you hate me so much? I mean, after all, I wasn't the third base coach who held up Alex Gordon and costed you the World Series.
Dan Walsh always timely with the humor. He's two World Series behind with that one.
He should have won. Some people say he would have been out. And I say that's the exact perspective someone from Kansas City would have, because they're losers and they don't understand taking a risk and it actually working for them.
Not unlike Dan Walsh to totally disregard recent information to make a point, an unfair
First
point.
First off, you're all welcome that you get to stare at me. You're welcome you get to take pictures of me. Hopefully your girlfriends have something to look at tonight and imagine that you're me. You want to see something really awesome, sir? You want to see something really amazing? You've been staring at it for like 5 minutes now. What's amazing is that you found that hat. That's what's amazing.
Well, folks, we're scheduled to have Dan Walsh against SBC, as well as another great matchup for the Metro Pro title, Derek Stone and Jake Durden on this broadcast. I didn't know if we'd ever get to that point, but luckily Dan Walsh actually handed over the microphone.
5 pounds from Star Island. Showtime, Bradley Charles!
Don Diablo with the official introduction. Showtime, Bradley Charles. We saw in our last episode of Metro Pro Wrestling come to the aid of both Matt Mitchell and Jeremy Wyatt. Surprisingly, he detailed some of the history him and Jeremy Wyatt have had here in Metro Pro Wrestling. Jeremy Wyatt certainly has had his trouble as of late with new head man around here, Michael Strider, as well as the likes of Mark Sterling and the King Brothers. Showtime Bradley Charles has a long history with all the men I've mentioned. And here he goes against Dan Walsh, former Central States champion, SBC and former Kansas champion. Certainly always in the mix for either one of those titles. And this match should go a long way to determining a challenger, perhaps for that Kansas championship. As we saw recently, Mark Sterling defeated Matt Fitchett to become the most recent number one contender for the Central States championship. Nice reaction for SBC from this hometown crowd. Always great to be here in Kansas City with you all, one of my favorite cities in the world today. And I appreciate all the kindness that fans have shown me through the years here in the Kansas City area. Referee Michael Craze has the duties on this one, one of the top refs in the country today, senior official here at Metro Pro. And this should be a dandy matchup, for sure. Dan Walsh, underhanded rule breaker. His technical wrestling has really come a long ways. He's a heck of a brawler. SBC, a great technician trained by Lance Storm up in Calgary, Alberta, Canada.
Why would I get in when you're holding that silly?
Dan Walsh, he loves to play the mind game. He likes to work in a psychological advantage. Many would say, you know, over pound for pound, as far as wrestling skills go, Dan Walsh doesn't have the athletic ability and the technical ability of an SBC, but that's where the likes of Lucy Mendez comes in. That's where the loudmouth, brash demeanor comes in. If he gets in your head, and if Lucy catches your eye, that's all the opening Dan Walsh needs to pick up a big victory. And he's had a number of great victories here in Metro Pro Wrestling. Keep in mind, he holds a singles victory over ACH, who really can count on one hand the number of men he's lost to here in Metro Pro. And here we go. Thought we were going to have the collar and elbow tie-up. Dan Walsh takes a powder immediately. He's certainly taking his time getting into this bag. And he's hearing it from these fans here at the Turner Rec Center, the home of professional wrestling in the Kansas City area. You know, Dan Walsh regularly insults the fans for their appearance and their intellect, and quite frankly, I don't have a clue what the hell's going on with Dan Walsh's hairstyle tonight, but neither does this crowd. But I'm sure he'll vouch for it either way.
I just stretched, dude. I just stretched. You don't even know it's coming, do you?
Walsh is really taking his time to stretch himself out. It's too bad he didn't have all day to do this in the locker room area before the match.
About time.
Of course, if you've ever had a conversation with Dan Walsh, you weren't part of it.
Just saying, dude, just saying.
Spent so much time chatting in the back, regaling the locker room, those that will listen, with his exploits and his stories for his time on MTV. He was part of Road Rules, as well as two editions of the Road Rules Real World Challenge. So no stranger to television. SBC now. Now he's throwing it right back at Dan Walsh. Because let me tell you something, Dan Walsh has got a huge ego. The feedback of the crowd means a lot to him. He's got a very thin skin. And if SBC can get the crowd firmly on his side and get Dan Walsh frazzled, all this early stanza, all this early work on the part of Dan Walsh is really for naught. Saw recently on Metro Pro Mike Seidel defeating Tyler Cook to become the new Kansas champion. That's a championship SBC has held, and in fact, he was a previous champion before Tyler Cook. Really, if you look at the history of Metro Pro Wrestling, guys like SBC, Mike Seidel, Tyler Cook make up a huge part of that Kansas championship division. Dan Walsh really surprised a lot of people when he won the Central States title, but he is certainly a very tough customer, a very smart competitor. I would say, if anything, what he lacks in overall wrestling ability, he certainly makes up with a pretty dynamic intellect. It's a very smart, savvy competitor. And look at this. We are, how are we almost 5 minutes into this bout? And we have yet to have so much as either man touch one another here. As Dan Walsh explains some of the dance skills, some of the brain power to the crowd. Dan Walsh, certainly an athlete, focus on that green power. Oh, my God. Now, what is going on here? Michael Craze taking his moment to shine. Now, this is an underappreciated man, Michael Craze. And certainly the fans here in Metro Pro generally have a positive reaction to the fine work of our referees. You know, it's the most unforgiving job in professional wrestling today, that of being the referee. There's not enough eyewear, not enough eyes, not enough vision availability to see everything all the time. Dan Walsh runs back into the ring after he Now, the thing is, if Dan Walsh truly leaves the ring and leaves the match, that's a forfeit, and that's a lot less money in his pocket, and he lives an expensive lifestyle. And Dan Walsh is focused on that green power. We're talking about the dollar bills, y'all. The green power, the money. The money and the big earnings you make here in Kansas City as part of Metro Pro Wrestling. Every match is important, regardless if you have a rivalry or not with the given individual, because there's a lot of money at stake here. Especially in Dan Walsh's situation, I don't know what sort of business relationship he has set up with Lucy Mendez, but you'd have to assume she gets a cut of whatever he can win here tonight, if he can win, and the key part of that is actually locking up. And here we go, Colorado will tie up Dan Walsh immediately. It's the arm wrench. Look at that. So after all the pageantry, if you will, Dan Walsh strikes first after all. Working away on that left arm. Spins around again. Twice with the arm wringer. Some technical wrestling by Dan Walsh into the hammerlock, into the side headlock. He's got the hands gripped. Side headlock takeover. SVC, it's unusual to see him on the receiving end of some technical wrestling display. SVC, quick rollover there into the pinning predicament. Dan Walsh. Size-wise, these two match up very evenly. Dan Walsh certainly in a better position right now as he's putting the majority of his body weight on the shoulders of SBC, who wisely uses his legs to advantage. That's what he had available to work with, and he used the tools at his workout. At the head scissors, Dan Walsh, knowing his placement in the ring, got the foot on the bottom rope. Oh, now he's got Lucy checking over that hairstyle. I don't think there's enough you can do to check over that hairstyle unless you're looking for lice. Collar elbow tie up. Oh, throws him down by the cornrows. Dan Walsh misses the elbow drop. That's just going to get SBC fired up. Big drop kick. Beautiful placement. One to the shoulder, one to the side of the jaw. Two in a row there. Great targeting on that drop kick. Kicks him in the midsection, the ultimate equalizer. Big shot to the back, sets up the big neck breaker. Cover. Kick out there by Dan Walsh. As annoying as I think he is, I gotta give him credit for his toughness. It's gonna take a lot more than that to put away Dan Walsh. SVC going to the second rope now. Busting out a heavy hitting move here in the early going. Big! Wow, what an elbow there by SBC. Beautiful execution. Flew about 12 feet across the ring on that one. Oh! The shoulder up just after two by Dan Walsh. Yeah! Oh, Dan Walsh cuts him off there. And in that momentum of SBC setting up. Got him in face lock, suplex position, slingshots him onto the top rope. Very dangerous position for SBC. Oh, what a kick by Dan Walsh. Side kick to the rib cage. Pointing the toe on the kidneys as well. Some martial arts styling here by Dan Walsh, unexpected. But you never know what to expect from a reality star, that's for sure. Tosses him off very hard.
That's a thing. That's in the rules.
Now the ropes,
that's
folks, keep in mind, well, that's just an easy term for him. That is just pure metal steel cable with a little bit of tape around it. And the way he flung him off there, putting extra force and assault on the rib cage, he just attacked. Dan Walsh really now putting together a nice display, a nice balanced attack on SBC. Now he's got him in a grounded abdominal stretch position to where he can punch away at the ribs as well. Now he's turning him further away from the ropes. SBC has his eyes firmly on the referee, but Dan Walsh, great maneuvering on his part. Big knee to the midsection as he's really working over both the rib area and the lower back of SBC. And he got the ribs again there. Big shot there. I'm not used to these kicks, and they're very impressive, and the technique is spot on from Dan Walsh. Ooh, big right hand to the eye as SBC tried to fight back. Dan Walsh throws a hell of a punch, no doubt about that. One of the better pound-for-pound strikers you'll find anywhere in the Midwest. Irish whip. SBC with the counter elbow. Up to the second rope again. Oh, went for a cross body. Well scouted by Dan Walsh. Drops him down with the gut buster on the knee. SBC is in a lot of pain and a lot of agony. And who would have thought from our early going, those opening minutes of Dan Walsh playing the mind game, screwing around, quite frankly, that he'd be in this position right now. Big senton. Could be enough with all the damage. Oh, 2.5. Really, that could have been enough with all the damage that's happened to SBC's midsection. He's as tough as they come. He's a heck of a competitor, but Dan Walsh is a very focused, very smart attack thus far here in the wrestling part of this bout. Fires him up. Oh, head-to-head meeting there. Two trains crashing at an Old State Fair. We are down. A lot of momentum there as he pushed Walsh off hard into the ropes. And head-on collision. That's the type of collision that'd get you a fine and missing a game or two in the NFL for sure. SBC inviting Dan Walsh to come at him. Now they're firing shots. They're really ragtagging each other here. Big right hand by SBC. He's really come a long way as far as the quality of his punches throughout his six-year career. Ooh, big chop. Oof-da. Irish whip, reversal by Walsh. Kick to the chest there. Big clothesline by SBC. Nailed him. Close him with the elbow. Now he's fired up. You might have a second win here. Charges into the corner. Big splash. Wow. Another chop. He's lighting them up now. Dan Walsh is in agony. Big Europeans, big chops. Nice display of strikes by SBC. And the crowd is really firmly behind him here. Dan Walsh misses the haymaker clothesline. Oh, the leg lariat. Trademark move of his trainer, Lance Storm, and a trademark of his own. Oh, shoulder up there by Dan Walsh. Great strike there. Now, wait a minute. Revolucha? Revolucha? What is Revolucha doing here? When Revolucha, a man we've seen make sparring appearances here in Metro Pro. Can't say I've ever seen him use those dance moves before. What is going on here? But the problem is SBC has got his attention turned toward him.
And he's what are you doing?
Come on. Bradley Charles has got to know. He can't let that happen. Oh, my God. Nice ability there into the toss. Wow. T-boned him. What a counter by SBC doing the splits. That's a sign of the athletic ability. Now Revolucha barefoot. A barefoot Revolucha on the ropes. Dan Walsh hits him, though. Thanks to the teamwork of SBC. Oh! O'Connor roll up almost had it. I got to say, for being distracted by him, SBC has managed to minimize the effect of Revolucha and, in fact, almost used him to his advantage there. What is Revolucha doing out here, quite frankly? Now Michael Craze is checked by Walsh. Revolucha from behind, come on! Walsh has got the tights and the roll up, and he's got the win!
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your
unbelievable.
Contest, the Dynamo.
Big win for Dan Walsh. What does Revolucha have to do with any of this? Yeah, you never know what's going to happen here in Metro Pro Wrestling. And quite frankly, I thought if there was going to be an underhanded win, Lucy Mendez would help. Now Lucha's got a bat! Is that a bat? Could be a nightstick of some sort. Oh, come on! Camel clutch with a nightstick, choking away, put all that pressure on the chin. The match is already over. You've already cost SBC a lot of money here tonight. What is this about? What is going on here? Oh, he's got him set up. Russian leg sweep with the nightstick! And he has done a tremendous amount of damage with that weapon. Wait a minute. Oh, now come on. Those are very recognizable tattoos, folks. Mike Seidel! Mike Seidel, our new Kansas champion. Not conducting himself in any way like a champion. What now? What is he doing out here? Namaste, yeah, this really ties in with the beliefs of yoga, Seidel. Absolutely ridiculous. Let's get SBC some help out here. Folks, we'll be back after these messages.
Hey, Colt Cabana, how you doing? Well, I'm Colt Cabana, and I'm doing fantastic, and you are doing just as well because you're watching Metro Pro Wrestling.
Welcome back to Metro Pro Wrestling, and welcome to Metro Pro Wrestling, J.J. Garrett. Yes, wrestling fans, J.J. Garrett, one of the top charismatic, young, fun athletes in the Midwest today, has made his way to Kansas City for the first time. Don't let the appearance fool you. He tries to be hip, tries to be cool. He's a great technical wrestler, a great high flyer. But he says he's the doctor of swagonomics. Yes, the swag master, J.J. Garrett. Nice dance of stylings there. His wardrobe seems to represent a number of decades all at once. But he's got a tough test ahead of him here tonight against the former Kansas champion, Tyler Cook. Get back on that winning track after losing the Kansas Championship recently to Mike Seidel.
Tyler Cook!
Diablo with the formal introduction of our former champion, Tyler Cook, mainstay here in Metro Pro Wrestling, Kansas born and bred. Showcase Tyler Cook. Last Tiger t-shirt. Yes, he is quite the 80s pop culture enthusiast. He has a blog, in fact, that keeps about 80s pop culture. This should be an interesting mix of styles and pop culture dynamics. You may have noticed the theme music of J.J. Garrett certainly has a appearance similar to that of A.C. Slater. By the bell. Garrett actually claims he's from Bayside, California. Zach and Slater and the gang all went to school there in Bayside, which is really from my record keeping. J.J. Garrett actually was a successful high school wrestler in the state of Iowa, out of Boone, Iowa, so he must have made the big move to the West Coast upon graduation. And really, he's made a name for himself across the country as one of the top young, high-flying technical talents today. Regularly competes in Dreamwave Wrestling, made his debut in Shikara Pro Wrestling just last weekend. He's going up against a veteran of the mat game, Tyler Cook, who's really impressed, really made that Kansas championship into one of the top titles in the Metro Pro area. Has had quite a history with the Kansas title since the inception of Metro Pro Wrestling.
A lot of chicken. I got several family things, yeah. Shirts.
This should be a great matchup. First time battle between these two. Yeah, J.J. Garrett. Proud of his body, proud of his swag. I don't know if he can be proud of his dance moves quite yet, but he's got a lot of confidence. But you don't want to be overconfident, especially for a lack of experience as far as years and in-ring matches go. Well, this should be a great match. I've been looking forward to this one all night. Here we go. Good spring to the step of J.J. Garrett. Calling him able to tie up there. Quickly into a waist lock. Tyler Cook bridges his way out of it. Look at that. The amateur stylings of Garrett in play here right away, rolling out of that predicament. Tyler Cook himself was a pretty high-level high school wrestler in the state of Kansas. Yeah. As you see, into the cradle there. And we have a full-on true amateur matchup here in the early going. Which, given the style choices of these gentlemen on the way out to the ring, just shows you can't judge a book by its cover, as we're at a standstill here after a nice series of roll-up counters and escapes from both men. Tyler Cook hits him in the midsection, the ultimate equalizer, and just like that, what I thought was going to maybe be a great amateur matchup has devolved into a slugfest on the part of Tyler Cook. J.J. Garrett, though, responding in time with a chop of his own. Oof, God, man alive. You hear that back in the Waffle House down the road. Another one by J.J. Garrett. And whoever's going to come out of this is going to be able to buy a couple more waffles tonight. Big money at stake here. Head to the buckle. Tyler Cook, this should be a real back and forth contest. Reversal there by Garrett. Charges in, up and over. Cook thought he countered it. No. Hits him in the midsection, does Garrett. Oh, look. Oh, into a side headlock there. Now, to Tyler Cook's credit, he's done his scouting. He knows J.J. Garrett loves to use actually, believe this or not, a DDT style move out of that predicament. Tyler Cook positioned his own body out of the way just enough that Garrett had to change it up into the headlock attempt. Nice head scissors there by J.J. Garrett, satellite style. Satellite head scissors on cable TV. How about it, folks? Big forearm smash. Irish whip. Oh, Tyler Cook, what a counter there. Slides through J.J. Garrett up and over. Tried to catch himself on the ropes. He did. Look at that. Big forearm smash. Garrett's up top. He's such a... Oh, wow. Meets the inverted atomic drop into the big short arm clothesline cover. Shoulder up. These guys, this is a real fast-paced contest here in the early going. I'm not surprised by that, but it'll be interesting to see if Cook tries to slow it down here, if he tries to keep up that traditional speed that he enjoys. But tonight he's actually facing a speedier athlete in J.J. Garrett. He really wants to impress his Metro Pro debut. Big suplex there by Tyler Cook. Nice strategy there. Turns him away from the ropes into a rear chin lock. He's got the knee firmly planted inside the shoulder blade, inside that right shoulder blade. There's some extra muscle mass, but extra nerve endings in that spot. Garrett up though, just like that. And another big forearm smash. Tyler Cook just couldn't keep that submission hold applied. Irish whip reversal fits the buckle hard as J.J. Garrett. Tyler Cook went in for the clothesline. No need, as he'd done just enough damage already from the Irish whip. It's a good time to point out. Saw the strength on display there of Tyler Cook. He's actually bulked up, added about 10 pounds, been working on upper body strength. And he has a size advantage here, which is a rarity for Tyler Cook. Drops the million-dollar fist. Tyler Cook getting frustrated, but it's going to take a lot more than that to put away J.J. Garrett. Despite being a young athlete, Garrett, a very accomplished competitor. Former King of Des Moines tournament winner. He's a pretty successful tag team going with another great young talent named Harvey Bauer. Swag Team is their name. Put a hashtag in front of it. Be hip like all the kids. Big into... Tyler Cook's got him up. Oh! Wow! Delayed! Backbreaker there. Tilt-A-Whirl backbreaker with a delay. What a tactic by Tyler Cook. The blood rushing to the head. You get whipped around even faster. And then the disorientation in your head space, and you have to deal with that lower back pain. As he's got the chin lock applied here. Garrett quickly is fighting out of this one. Four elbows. Hits the ropes. Oh, Cook pulls him back by the belt. No, up and over this goes Garrett. Cook misses the clothesline. Big clothesline by Garrett. And another one. And another one, seated style. What momentum there on that clothesline, and now J.J. Garrett's got that burst of energy. The crowd is rallying behind him. Big running forearm smash. Hits the corner hard again. Big spear. Look at this. Three in a row. Into what a flip by J.J. Garrett. Tremendous combination of moves. The forearm, the shoulder, and then the flip. Nailing all points of Tyler Cook's body. He's got to capitalize here, though. This is a great opportunity. He's encouraging Cook back up to his feet. I don't know if that's the strategy to take right now, Garrett. Into a discus lariat. Good grief. Oh, shoulder her up. my apologies to Garrett for questioning his strategy. He clearly sensed what was upon him. Garrett, for being a young athlete in his third year as a pro, he has a great sense of timing, has a great sense of where to be at in the ring. And now he's dragged Cook. Look at the way he dragged him right to where he needs him to be, going up top. Could be that swag splash. Check it out, folks. Big, oh, a frog splash variation. The swag splash misses, as he almost flew directly off your TV screen there. This is Tyler Cook's opportunity. He's got him in prime position. Garrett misses the clothesline, going for the T-bone. He hits that, it's over. Garrett fights out of it, though, into a big scoop power slam. And Garrett kicks out. Great job by JJ Garrett, kicking out of that power slam. Been a tremendous contest thus far. Win or lose, good debut here for JJ Garrett. And Tyler Cook knows he's really been in a fight. Big jawbreaker counter there by Garrett off the forearm, smashes a Cook. It's interesting to see so many strikes in this bout, because truly technical wrestling high flying is more their forte than striking. But Garrett stunned him with that last one, nice little jab forearm. Cook misses the big elbow. Garrett's got him up. What a move by JJ Garrett! Incredible move! Oh, wow! Got him up in a back suplex position and just came crashing down almost with a clothesline style slam. It's that burst of power. JJ Garrett has just a very powerful frame. He's a very powerful athlete in a small package. It comes out in short bursts. Another series of forearms, another distance Larry misses. T-bone by Tyler Cook, spun him inside out. Doomsday for Garrett, cover. And he kicks out again! How is he getting, wow. I was about to say, you count to 10, he's done, but JJ Garrett finds a way. The crowd is really impressed here by JJ Garrett. What spirit, what heart by JJ Garrett. Reversal by Garrett. Up and over goes Tyler Cook. Rolls through. Oh, kicks him in the face as he climbs the top rope. Wow, went for a tumbleweed splash. Garrett with the crucifix pin. He got him. The amateur stylings workout for JJ Garrett with the crucifix roll up pin. What a debut for JJ Garrett here at Metro Pro Wrestling, knocking off the former Kansas champion. Impressive battle there. Impressive showing from both men. JJ Garrett picking up a huge victory in his Metro Pro Wrestling debut. Crowd very impressed. What a win here for JJ Garrett. Making dance his way to the pay window. Gonna get some more of those flashy clothes at the thrift shop. We'll be back with more after this, right here on Metro Pro Wrestling.
You know, I'm here in a cellar because, like a good wine, things take time to mature. And I have been in this business a very long time. I would say that my vintage is ready. There's lots of guys out there that are like me, that have taken the time to set and reflect. And I've seen guys come and go in this business, just cheap wine, nasty. You don't want to have it. But when you want something special, when you want something that really fits the palate, that's when you go down into the cellar and you grab the best vintage, the oldest vintage. Gets better with age. You pop that cork, championships, celebrations are made, you toast to a new era, to a new vintage.
Gentlemen.
Hey.
Calm down.
We're not here to fight you, obviously. We just helped you.
Obviously. Guys. We're in a dark cellar right now.
Look, that's not the place. There's no doubt that you guys are a better tag team than the Kings. There's no doubt about that.
No question.
You're the second best tag team in this whole company.
If you wanted to come down here and start degrading us after a loss.
That's not why I'm here. Look, there's no doubt we have history. You guys don't like us. We don't really care for you.
Yeah.
But we respect you guys as a team. But you guys know as well as we do, we can't beat the Kings, the Bulldogs, Mark Sterling, dealing with Michael Strider by ourselves. Eventually, we're going to have to align. You're going to have to trust that we're thinking about the best interest of this company. May not have always done that. Sure, we're kind of selfish, but in this instance, I mean, the proof is in the pudding. They were going to end your career, and we came and saved you. So I think we need to come together, take these guys out, and whoever wins the tag titles back first, whether it's you guys,
me and Vega will win the titles.
But if it's us or you, we'll give you guys a shot. If you do the same for us, we just need to get rid of those guys.
So this is a, we'll scratch your back if you scratch our back.
Well, we'll watch your back so your career don't get ended, because there's 5-6 of them and only 2 of you and only 2 of us.
Listen, there's an army forming against us.
Right.
And 2-on-2, we can't take them.
Right.
2-on-7, 2-on-8, it's going to get over. But the more we align, the more we team up, the more we put our differences aside, the better shot we've got.
Just think about it. You don't got to make the decision right now, right down here in the basement. Take some time to think about it. But what happened tonight, I mean, the Bulldogs, they weren't even out there. That was just the Kings going to end you. Just think about it, okay?
Why are they in a basement?
It's a dark room. Depression. We need to think about this. I don't know if I trust them fully yet.
We should talk to our sensei.
What's up? I'm Tito Ortiz here at Punishment Training Casino, and you're watching Metro Pro Wrestling.
Welcome back to Metro Pro Wrestling, and welcome to Main Event City, and it doesn't get any bigger than this. Two of the most intimidating forces in wrestling today going at it for the Metro Pro Wrestling Heavyweight Championship. The challenger, Jake Durden, 6'8" tall, near 300 pounds, a wrecking machine. This man has toured pro wrestling Noah in Japan, where he decimated the young Japanese talent. He's held championships everywhere he's been, except right here in Metro Pro Wrestling. A force to be reckoned with out of the St. Louis area, a dominant presence in Dynamo Pro Wrestling, has toured the country, toured the world. And now, he returns to Metro Pro, the challenge. 3-time champion Derek Stone for the heavyweight title here tonight. This should be a wild one. Notice the tape thumb there. He loves to use that Asiatic spike. Drives the thumb into the trachea, into the throat.
And right now, his opponent from Denver, Colorado, weighing 240 pounds, the man with many faces, and the defending Metro Pro Heavyweight Champion, Derek Stone!
Don Diablo with the formal introduction of our champion, Derek Stone, making his first defense of the title in his third reign here as champion. Look at this! Look at the mask! We thought Jake Durden was an intimidating presence. Look at the intimidating factor of that chain! The chain with a 3-inch hook on the end of it, 3-inch thick steel. Wait a minute! From the crowd, who's this? That's Derek Stone right there! Derek Stone's coming from the crowd! Now, who is that in the entranceway? Pushes a fan aside, and the champion is attacking from the behind. And the fight is on. Here we go. The referee stunned. Don Diablo can't even get out of the ring in time, and the fight is on. The champion attacks. Smart strategy, as underhanded as it is. The 20-plus year veteran knows this youngster, Jake Durden, still has less than 5 years' experience. It is actually a tremendous threat to his championship, as look at that big forearm smash by Durden, responding in kind of the forearms of Stone, standing on his feet, kicks the man in the face. Now he snots up the rag, and he snots up the face of Derek Stone. This is a wild one. These guys are real skull crackers, and this is what the heavyweight championship is all about, a real fight. Derek Stone tossed inside out on the turnbuckles there. And he is destroying big destiny plunge. Stone hits the floor very hard, that unforgiving wooden floor. Big shoulder block there by Durden, and he has the champion very damaged. Stone is in a lot of trouble here in his very first defense since winning the title in controversial fashion over Jeremy White. Wow, Durden with a bite now. Won the title in controversial fashion over Jeremy Wyatt with the help of Michael Strider in that battle. We know the issues at play with Strider and Wyatt currently. Actually, our next episode of Metro Pro Wrestling will feature Jeremy Wyatt challenging National Star, TNA Star, Ring of Honor Star, Christopher Daniels, the Fallen Angel, making his Metro Pro debut. As these two are spilling out into the crowd, the referee, using his discretion, follows them out. These championship bouts are very important. And all the props to the referee for allowing these two to battle it out. But caution, fans. Oh, Durden head first into the steel ring post. Yeah, two brawlers really in their element. Two of the top brawlers in the country today. Keep in mind, Stone has brawled in the crowd more times than Durden's even having a traditional wrestling match throughout his illustrious career. As they go up the steps now, they're nearing our camera. They're nearing our hard camera up there. Proceed with caution. You get a nice big look at the beard of Durden there. The frosty mug as Durden fires away. Charges down after Stone, who's made his way into the crowd is parting like the Red Sea. Nice work by our production crew to follow this action. Big back rake by Durden. Those dirty fingernails. Don't know what type of fungus is underneath there. Oh! Into the railing. Stone responds in kind. But these two aren't giving up. These two are just absolutely not going to give it up. Oh, wait a minute. Stone is teasing a suplex over the railing. Now, that's about a 6-foot drop to the floor right there. Just a wooden floor, and actually there's all sorts of chairs underneath there. And looking at, from my vantage point, yes, they're actually near the concession area right now. And Stone has fallen directly into the concession area. The referee checks on him. These aren't your standard human beings. These are, they are of a different constitution. This is Wild Man Durden. Just steps over the railing and pounds away on Derek Stone. Head first into that table. Recycled milk cartons coming to the aid of Durden in his assault on Stone and a Diet Coke to the face. Diet Coke to the face. Oh, look like, is that a walking taco? Stone walking tacos Durden right in the eye. This is a wild one. This is absolutely wild. Yes, now Stone has got that barricade. Wraps it around the throat of Durden. I think approximately 30 seconds of this bout has actually been in the ring. Well, thus far, we've had approximately 6 minutes of action of fighting on the outside. This pace, I don't know how far long they can keep up this pace. They're in great endurance, but that was a heck of a battle on the outside. What a brawl. Drives the knee into the eyeball of Durden. Certainly they're not working over a traditional body part as of yet. Now, after all that, Stone with a snapmare. And absolutely, why not? He's pulling the hair. Pulling the hair of Durden. That thick mane. Look at the beards on these men. These guys are wild and woolly man alive. Big clubbing forearm smash. Stone's got the hair again. Now he's fish hooked him. It's not a legal submission hold, but it is effective. Very effective. Stone. You know, in the past, he's been quite a jovial guy. Done some dancing. Big fan of soft rock and roll. But underneath that all, underneath that soft demeanor, there's a vicious individual. An absolute vicious individual. Big right hands there by Durden. Look at that Mongolian chop of sorts by Stone. And a headbutt to the chest cavity, right to the heart. Oh, and another one. That looked a little low, ref. That looked pretty low in the placement. Stone's indicating it was lower abdominal area. I don't know about that. But after all that brawling on the outside, the veteran has found a way to minimize the young bull's advantage here. Using the combination of strikes and headbutts. Now he's got a front face lock applied. He's got that locked in, that guy tight. This is a submission predicament right in the center of the ring. Durden's got that long frame, but I don't know if he can, yes, he's not in no position to get his foot back to the rope to break this. He's gonna have to use his will, his fortitude, his upper body strength. He stands up to a vertical base, big rights and left with that long wingspan. Another big right hand. Oh, Stone kicks him in the midsection. Oh, just clubs him over the eye. What a shot there by Derek Stone. Irish whip, reversal. Stone hits hard, big charging boot. Man alive, what a knockout blow. Stone is beyond stunned. This is the chance at the Asiatic spike. Oh, big right hand. Setting it up here, big headbutt. Very few men have ever headbutt Derek Stone and actually hurt Stone. Durden is one of them. Oh, went for that big spike, I think. Oh, Durden blocks the shot by Stone with his foot. What a technique. Now he's got, these guys are just going at it. Irish whip. Stone misses the big Larry close. Oh, Polish hammer there by Jake Durden. He's signaling now, holding that thumb up to the sky. This could be the end of Stone's reign and the beginning of Durden's top wrestling championship reign. Oh, misses the spike. Stone with a roll up. A roll up, he's got the tights. Stone, after all that, after that brawl, Derek Stone has defended the championship with a schoolboy roll up. Controversial finish, he clearly had a hold of the pants. But after a crazy brawl like that, the veteran, with a savvy maneuver, comes out with the victory with a roll up. If you had placed your bets on that type of finish for that, you'd be raking in the cash right now. So is Derek Stone, big championship bonus. Durden is furious. And folks, another great episode of Metro Pro Wrestling in the books. We will see you again next time here on Metro Pro Wrestling.